Now, last session we have completed with important engineering materials properties, right? In this session we are going to see ferrous materials and types of ferrous materials. This is Faizan Kagdi and I welcome you all to our lecture series of basic mechanical engineering. So let's begin with our topic. Ferrous materials. The raw material for all ferrous metal is a pig iron. Pig iron is obtained by smelting the iron in a blast furnace with the help of coke and limestone. The commonly used ferrous metals are first wrought iron. So it is highly refined iron with small amount of slag formed out into fibers. It contains as much as 99% iron. It is tough, malleable and ductile. Bolts, nuts, chains, crank, hooks, railway couplings are the main form which are obtained from wrought iron. Second is steels. So it is an alloy of carbon and iron with carbon content usually ranging from 0.08 to 1.5%. Now this value you need to keep in mind, percentage value, that is 0.08% to 1.5%. Okay. Now steel generally contains small amount of sulfur, silicon and manganese. The carbon steel can be classified into three types. So first type is low carbon steel, that is 0.15 to 0.3%. It is used for steel structure, for building bridge, ships, etc. Second is medium carbon steel. That is a composition content of carbon 0.3 to 0.6%. Now it is used for manufacturing of connecting rods of IC engine, then crank, crane hooks, then railway wheels, etc. And third type, that is high carbon steel, has a carbon content of 0.6 to 1.5%. Used for manufacturing of dies, saws, cutting tools, piston rings, etc. Our next important material is alloy steel. Now in alloy steel, elements other than carbon are added in sufficient amount to produce improvements in properties. Alloy steel can give a better strength, ductility and toughness than plain carbon steel. The commonly added elements includes nickel, chromium, silicon, manganese, tungsten, cobalt, etc. The main type of alloy steel used in practice are first stainless steels, second heat resisting steels, third high speed steels, fourth spring steels. Now next type is cast iron. So it is primarily an alloy of iron and carbon. The carbon content in cast iron varies from 2 to 4.3%. Various types of cast iron used are as follows. So you can see the first type is called a gray cast iron. So when a carbon is present in a form of graphite flakes, the cast iron called is a gray cast iron. So the important term is carbon is in a form of graphite flakes. Okay. Next. These iron castings are widely used for machine tools bodies, flywheels, pipe fittings, etc. So these are the applications of gray cast iron. Next type of cast iron is a white cast iron. So it contains carbon in a form of cementite. Because of that, the color of this is white. Okay, so because of that, it is also called as a white cast iron. It is used in manufacturing of mill liners, pump liners, grinding balls, etc. Next type of cast iron includes malleable cast iron. It is produced by giving long heat treatment to white cast iron at sufficiently high temperature ranging from 900 degrees Celsius to 950 degrees Celsius and then allowed to cool down slowly. It is widely used in automotive industry. So remember the application of this cast iron used in automotive industry. They are also used for hubs of wagon wheels, parts of agriculture machinery. Now next we need to see non-ferrous metals. Okay, So non-ferrous metals contains metal other than iron as the main constituent, as we have discussed in our last session, right? Now, the commonly used non-ferrous metals are aluminium and its alloys. Okay, so aluminium is silvery type white metal, lighter in weight than steel and copper. So steel is basically a ferrous metal, whereas copper is a non-ferrous metal. So aluminium is comparatively lighter and it is mainly used in airplanes parts. Okay, because we require lightness. Okay, now it has a high electrical and thermal conductivity and good machinability, formability and castability. So as it is written, it is used in aircraft and automobile industry, as well as cooking utensils and electrical wires are made from aluminium. Okay, next is copper and its alloys. So it is a soft, malleable and ductile material with reddish brown appearance. It is a good conductor of electricity. Now there are mainly two types of copper alloys. So first is brass. Now it is an alloy of copper and zinc, which means the main constituent which are involved in making brass are copper and zinc. Now next application, we can see that it is used in hydraulic fittings, pump cleanings, then in making utensils and bearings. Okay, that is ball bearing, roller bearing, then rolling contact bearing, then sliding contact bearing. In that we can use brass material. Okay, next we need to see bronze. So we would say that it is an alloy of copper and tin. It resists surface pure, that is wear and tear it can resist, then can be cast into shapes and rolled into wires, which means we can form wire from bronze, then rolls and sheets very easily. Okay, so bronze has a good castability. Now next we need to see that is non-ferrous is steel. So it is brightly shining white, soft and malleable metal. It is used for making fine shoulder, tin foil used and used for moisture proof packing. So up till here we would say that this is a non-ferrous material metal parts. Now let us see our non-metal parts. Okay, so now next topic, non-metallic material. So first come timber. It is obtained by cutting trees after their full growth. Wood is natural polymer composite. It is widely used for making door window, roof members, furniture, railway sleepers, sport goods, etc. Now second material is composite material. It is a combination of more than one material which are used in combination to rectify a weakness in one material by strengthening another material. Composite may be man-made or natural. Next type of non-metallic material is ceramics. So it is consisting of compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements. Ceramic materials have a greater stability at high temperature and they are very brittle and less ductile. Ceramics are used in a field of heat engines, electronic packaging, gas turbines, chemical reactor linings, etc. Next material is glass. We know it is a non-metallic material made up of a transparent silica. So it is a transparent silica product which may be amorphous or crystalline depending on heat treatment. You know the property of glass, that is brittleness. Now let's see the application of glass. So it is used for glass equipments for various use due to its better optical properties, chemical stability, non-corrosive nature and high temperature resistance. Our next material is diamond. So it is an allotrope of carbon and the hardest non-material. It is the hardest and toughest material. Even it is used as a cutting tool in machining operation. Okay, it is widely used in drilling and other finishing operations like latting, honing and super finishing. Next type, plastics. It is usually divided into two groups. First thermoplastic and second thermosetting plastics. They are mostly used in manufacture of automobile parts, safety glasses, laminated gears, self-lubricating bearings. Okay guys, so with this we are completing with our chapter. In next session we will start with our new chapter, that is transmission of motion and power. Till then, stay tuned and thank you all.